Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of my SimCity city construction project. It's been a while since I did the previous part. I've actually pretty much forgotten what I was doing. But that's the joy of a game like SimCity, where you can save it and then come back anytime in the future. It is a bit unfortunate that the source code for the game is not available. I can understand why the makers are still actually able to sell it, so why not keep it private and make more money on it? However, if they would clean up the source code they have and make, you know, I'd compile it with some optimization, the game might run a little bit faster, particularly on the load-up stage. Let's see. What have I got here? Okay, so I have a gap here to fill in. And I have an area here. Okay, so I'm not sure quite what I'm going to do here. Well, what's the demands look like? Okay, so it looks like I should probably set up some more high-tech industrial zoning. There seems to be a significant demand for that still. So I think I'll do that over here. Okay, so what have I got here? I have rail going through. And I have a passenger train station there. Okay. I think I'll put a freight train station there too. And I'll find that over here under rail. Passenger. Freight train station. Okay. Now, I need in here, I think I need a road in here somewhere. Okay, put one in here. Okay. Okay, what do I have here? I have 11, 4, 5, 6, I'll split it like this. Okay. And I'll split it like this. Okay, I think I like that. Now, water. And now for the zoning. Finally, I'll add some subway stops. Okay, now I need to link those up. Oops, wrong one. Okay. I guess I need to link that up with the rest of the network, which I can do this way. Okay. Okay, education's doing good. Looks like a mayor rating of 100. Okay. Well, I need to sort out a water situation here. Okay. It looks like I'm to the point where I probably need a third one of these. So I'll start by building one, and I'll demolish the old one, replace it, demolish that one, and replace it. And now we can see we're just under two-thirds usage, so water capacity should be quite good now for a while. Okay. That one's not gonna work unless I Now, isn't that just the weirdest shaped intersection ever built? Okay. Okay, good. That will work. Not exactly the best road layout ever invented, but these sorts of things do occur in real cities. For this to really work, I probably need to build a fairly substantial reconstruction here. Now, let's see. Well, clearly. That can't ever fill in. Realistically, I wanted to build the intersection right here, but SimCity doesn't allow a diagonal rail to go through the middle of a road or street intersection, even though that's what I wanted to do. I've actually seen a real intersection where a rail line went diagonally across it. It's a great way to confuse people when they come up on it. Okay, let's see how demands are doing here. Right, okay. I think I'll keep expanding the industrial area over here. Think. Yeah, I think I'll put a wider road along here, put an avenue. Okay, bring an avenue across here. And that means I can bring this one down here. Link up this. This can come through. Okay. One, two, three, four, five. No, I won't put that there. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Let's see how that intersection looks. Okay, yeah, I can live with that one. Okay. Yeah, this would be so much easier if diagonal streets worked better. Okay, so it looks like I'm going to end up replacing this. Actually, I think I'll take this crossing out. And okay, I think that's better. Now, next step, water. So I'll have a water main along here. Bring this one over, and that just about covers everything. Okay, good. Now for the zoning. And again, some subways. Put one here. One can go in here. Have one here. This seems like a good spot. Since this is so far away from a lot of the actual development for residential, having the subway lines out here actually makes the area more desirable because the workers can actually get here. Obviously, if the workers can't get there, it's not so good for the actual industries. Okay. Gonna save the game here so I don't lose what I've just done. Okay, now let's see what happens if we speed things up and let that develop a bit. It's generally a good idea to place industrial areas near the edge of the city because in the game mechanics, the industrial areas they need to ship their products out of the city. And if the freight trips end up being too long, the industries basically get unhappy and dilapidate or abandon. Now, I see that I have a power problem here brewing, so I'll take a look here And yep, I'm definitely coming up on a power problem. What is my power situation? Okay. Well, I'll pause the game and replace my power plant. Okay, it looks like I really should build a second power plant now. So I'm going to do that. Well, let's look at the budget first. Yeah, it's a little bit iffy, but I have a good reserve here, so I'll build another power plant and I'll put it over here. Right, okay. Now I'll speed things up, let things develop for a bit here. Okay, so demand on residential is rising. Oh wow, look at that. Agriculture demand went up. So I think what I'm going to end up doing in a future part is building some large, low density residential developments, kind of like this area here. I'll probably do that over here. I think this will be largely low density residential over here. I'm not sure what I'm going to do in this area, but certainly over here. And I think that'll spill over here as well. Probably down even around here. And since the high-tech industrial doesn't generate any appreciable amount of pollution, I can even develop it in here. I think that's what I'm going to do, actually. But I'll need to figure out how I'm going to lay that out. It's easiest if you have a grid. I do have a square area here, but grids aren't strictly required. Okay, yeah. Yeah, I think what I'll do is I'll start expanding the residential. I think once the residential population increases, the commercial demand will go back up as well. So I'll start out in this corner here. So the first thing I'm going to do is construct my bordering Well, actually, I'll make it a road on the bordering street. Okay. Now, I'll leave a gap here for commercial along the avenue there. And I'll leave another gap here. One, two, three. Yep. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, that'll be fine. Now, actually, if I move my streets all down one, I can have a four tile. Thing along here. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four, five. Maybe I don't have to. Seven. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Actually, I just divided it wrong. Two, three, four, five. Nope. I just placed the street wrong. Okay. So that'll come all the way out to here. Now, this just needs to have some cross streets here. Okay, and one more. It's okay if these blocks are fairly long. Okay, so I'm gonna want water. So I'll bring this down all the way across on these streets. Okay. Now, in here, I'm going to need some education. This one is overkill, but I'll go with it anyway. Now, okay. Okay. Actually, I'll make these. I'll make those industrial. Think I should probably put a gap here. I might need to change those to something else. Probably something with a stronger park effect. Well, I'll continue this all the way along here. What I really want here, I suppose, is probably some sort of a alley or a fence or something. But grass strip will do for now. I'm not sure what I'm going to do in here. I'll probably put some commercial stuff in there, maybe fill in some green space or something in there. Ultimately. Anyway, I think I'm going to call it a part here. So let's see, I should save this. Okay, so I'm definitely going to call it a part here. Next time, I'll look at expanding the residential development further to the west, and I'll look at filling in the rest of that gap there. And then after that, I'm not sure, probably some green space along the highway and so on. Anyway, that's all for this part. I'll see you next time.